as you come back down, I want you to tell me the very first thing that you see down there below you.
I see the sun. I'm right in front of the sun, like the big burning star. Fire is coming out. It's very hot there, and it's huge. It's very huge. And I see black symbols in this huge sea of fire and lava, and this planet spitting fire.
Wow. You said you see black symbols?
Mm-hmm.
Can you describe them?
They are round, but seem to be like stars with different jacks or tips, like different amounts. Some of them have 20 or 30 tips. Some of them are more edgy and have fewer tips. And I see a triangle with a black spot in the middle that is becoming bigger and bigger. I think this is important. And over the, like the pyramid or the triangle is pointing upwards, and over the triangle there's an eye, black eye staring at me.
Have you seen this symbol before?
Yes, I dreamed about it.
Does it remind you of something?
It's related to my heart. It's a connection.
Mm-hmm.
It's a key.
Mm-hmm. A key.
Mm-hmm.
How does it make you feel when you look at it?
It makes me feel very comfortable and warm, and I feel a lot of love. It's related to a higher source. Something, it's like a bridge or like an interface. I need this key to access another dimension or a higher source of consciousness. It's like a scripture or like a symbol, metaphor of energy.
Mm. What could it mean? Could you transcribe this symbol? What does the triangle mean, and the eye on the top? What is it trying to tell you?
It's telling me to find the source within myself.
Mm-hmm.
The triangle is actually a symbol of my own energetic system. Actually, I have it now, I see it around my body. I'm sitting in the pyramid.
Mm.
This is just a symbol of something that I have actually inside of me or around my physical body. It's not actually physical, but this manifestation of myself.
And why a triangle? What does a triangle mean?
It's there to focus energy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The things that are on the base of the pyramid, they focus energy to the top.
Mm-hmm.
And the energy that is coming out of the pyramid, I can direct it and communicate with other beings.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So you have used this symbol before?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Can you look at your body? Can you look at your feet?
Mm-hmm. My feet seem pretty big, strange, long. I have six or seven toes.
Okay.
My legs are very thin.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have a gender. I'm not male. I'm not female.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see any genitals.
Mm-hmm.
I have very, very long arms,
mm-hmm.
very long fingers.
How many fingers?
Four.
Mm. What color is your skin?
Rainbow metallic with a lot of purple. It's shiny.
Is it thick or more thin, transparent?
It seems to be liquid. It's thin and shiny, but liquid, it's moving. It's not something, not a, like a dense material, it's more fluid, liquid.
What about your head?
My head is big and long, not round, more long shape, huge eyes, huge bluish shiny eyes, small mouth, and not really a nose but two dots so I can breathe, and I don't have hair. And on my chest there's a golden symbol.
Can you describe it?
It's a pyramid, a golden pyramid facing downwards, and above the pyramid there's a diamond.
What color is the diamond?
Silver.
Silver
blue.
And is this a pendant, or is it, what kind of material is this symbol that is there on your chest?
A mixture of glass and metal.
So it's hanging from your neck, or how?
No, it's in my skin. It's not jewelry, it's in my skin. It's part of me.
Do you feel young or old?
Young.
Are you holding something? Are you carrying something? Are you having any jewelry on you besides the symbol or something else?
I have two golden spheres in my hands. They are also part of my skin. And in the right hand I hold a red-orange flower. But it's not a material flower, it's more like a energetic flower with a golden round stone in the middle. And the flower is burning.
It's burning really?
Yes, like the sun.
And on your other hand?
There's a purple pyramid. A purple half-transparent pyramid.
Why are you holding these items?
I brought them from another planet
to
give it to the sun.
Why would you like to do that?
Because on the sun there are species, like there live beings. Beings
inside.
Yes, inside the sun. They need these materials.
What for? How can they use them?
They plant it in the ground to, like, it's like a seed. They plant it in the ground and then it grows like a flower, like the little pyramid becomes a big pyramid. And the little flower I hold in my hand becomes a big flower. And they need the material to build the infrastructure. They have triangular pyramid houses. And the flowers, the big flowers, seem to be like a protection of the buildings.
What kind of protection? From what?
From the sun radiation, because it's so hot there.
But they live inside the sun? And how is it there, the landscape and the atmosphere? Is it like Earth, or is it different? Is there plantation, or how is it there?
Yes, the sky looks different. The sky is black and red with orange clouds, but the ground seems to be very green, but it's artificial green, it's not natural. They plant grass there. I can also see trees. Maybe they got it from the earth, I don't know. But it looks more artificial, like they, like a simulation or something.
And how did you get there?
You mean to the sun?
How did you travel there?
In my spaceship.
How does your spaceship look like?
It's white, black and purple.
Mm-hmm. White, black and purple.
The purple, like in the middle there's a purple triangle. It's the same material like the pyramid that I was holding in my hand.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe they need the material to build spaceships. Mm-hmm. And then around the middle purple triangle there's a white layer.
Mm-hmm.
Shiny white. I don't know what material, but it's very bright. And then a black layer. And underneath there are three engines. And yeah, it's not very big, but it's very fast.
How many people does it fit?
Four.
Mm-hmm. And you went there alone or with more people?
Right next to me, there's someone sitting that is very close to me.
Mm-hmm.
Completely looks like me, but has a different, the skin has a different texture. It's completely black. And the eyes are blue.
Mm.
And I see the middle, like the iris of the eyes looks actually human. But the eyes in general are very big.
But does he look like you? He comes from the same place than you? You came together?
Yes, but it's a little bit a different race. Like on Earth you have white people and black people.
Mm.
And there I have just a different skin and slightly different eyes, but we come from the same planet.
Mm, mm. Is your planet in the same universe or is it very far away? From the same galaxy, sorry.
No, it's not from the same galaxy. It's very far away.
Mm, mm. Is it the first time you go to the sun to do this or have you been there before?
No, I go there regularly.
Mm-hmm. And how do you communicate with the people there?
With vibrations coming out of my throat.
Mm-hmm.
But not words. It's mm-hmm. more like a tone, different frequencies of tones.
Mm-hmm. How do these people look like who live in the sun?
They are a little bit smaller than me and dense. And they are completely burning like a flame with eyes, but not a like a fixed silhouette. It's more like, yeah, like a flame. It's moving.
Mm. So you went there with this other person, you said, to give them this this elements, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And so what happens? You stay there or you just leave them and you go?
No, I go there to give them the material.
Mm-hmm.
Then I stay there and sing.
Mm-hmm.
I sing.
Mm-hmm.
And while singing, I create shapes and patterns mm-hmm. and colors. I do it for them because I love them.
Mm.
I do this every time when I go there. And then I go back to my planet and get more material.
Mm-hmm. How is your planet? Describe me. How does this place look like?
It looks like the planet is not completely round. It has a polygon structure.
Mm-hmm.
It's made from crystals, but the crystals are like crafted or the beings shape them, and when I go more into or near the surface of the planet, I see huge buildings, like it looks like a huge shell or something like this, completely black and like a skyscraper.
Mm-hmm.
And on the top of this huge skyscraper, there's a pine cone.
Mm.
And I see sacred geometry patterns. Ah, it's an energy generator.
Mm-hmm.
It's a connection to the cosmos generating energy.
Mm.
And giving it to the city I live.
Mm-hmm.
And the sky is dark black, dark purple.
Always like this or just now?
No, it's night. Ah, it's night. I see lights in the city. And the normal houses are made from glass pyramids. And I see planes, no, actually spaceships flying around.
Do they look like yours or you have different shapes and different styles?
No, the spaceships I see there have a different shape. They look like a big cigar with windows in the front. Very futuristic.
And how do you propel these ships?
What do you mean?
How do they work? With what kind of energy?
Huge white crystals.
Like quartz?
Yes, but it's a different quartz. It's not the same like on Earth. It has a shining rainbow structure, or it's made from various smaller crystals that, I mean, it's white, but if the light shines on the crystal, I see rainbow colors. It's a rare material. I don't know what kind of stone it could be.
And it's found in your planet, this crystal? Or you produce it in the laboratory?
It's not natural. You produce it.
You make it in the laboratory?
Yes.
And with this you generate energy and you propel your ships?
Yes, we put the crystals in the spaceship and there they generate a very high vibrating energy without any emissions.
For also for long distance trips?
Very long distance, yes.
Yeah. Are you coming to Earth as well sometimes?
No.
No. Does your planet have a name?
Garganta.
And you people, you also use, you communicate with telepathy? Or how do you communicate?
Yes, with thoughts, but not with sound. It's transmitted telepathically.
And are you eating? What are you eating, if you are eating?
We are inhaling shapes and colors.
Where do they come from? Where do you find them?
I see them all over the sky. They are just there. Different shapes, and like looks like mandalas and fractal patterns, and we can fly there and inhale them. So our body is nourished with light. Ah, actually, it's light. Light patterns. We eat light.
Where do these patterns and mandalas come from? And
they were given to us by a very highly developed race. Huge. They look like huge, white, furry birds. But not birds like we know them from Earth.
Okay.
Like a mixture of giants and birds with long white hair. Yes. They breathe it into
planet.
Yes, they breathe it into the sky for us.
Do they visit you, these beings, often?
Yes. Whenever we call them, they come and help us.
They are more advanced than you?
Yes. They don't need spaceships anymore.
So now I want you to go to the place where you live and look at the outside of it and tell me, how does it look like?
I see a garden with red roses and black panthers, and the panthers, they have rainbow eyes and they are connected with the roses. They share the same energy somehow.
How can you, could you explain that? How they are connected?
The panther sees the energy of the rose And by passing or walking next to the rose, he can focus on the signature, like the energetic pattern of the rose,
mm-hmm.
and take it into his system. So they kind of exchange
information,
yes.
Awesome. And how does your house look like?
It's a purple glass pyramid, and it has a golden sphere on top. There are no entries and no windows. Everything is completely transparent, and I can walk through walls. This is why I don't need any doors.
Mm-hmm. Is there any meaning of significance of the golden ball on the top?
It represents the sun.
Do you use it for something, like generating energy also, or is it just like...
Yes, it stores heat.
Mm-hmm. Energy from the sun.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. And how does it look inside? Go inside and...
Mm-hmm. There's the floor is black, and there's a triangular colorful pattern of light that is changing constantly.
On the floor?
Yes, on the floor. And
sounds
by
amazing.
And by thinking about the furniture, I can create it with my thoughts, so it's not something stable.
Mm.
I can change it whenever I want.
Very practical.
Yes.
Awesome. Are you sharing this space with somebody else, with other beings, or is it only
you? Yes, this black guy that was in my spaceship, he's living with me.
Mm.
Oh, and we are becoming one.
How do you do that?
We just walk into each other because we are kind of transparent or...
Not so dense.
No, not dense. So we walk into each other and we have two legs, but then the body separate, and we have four hands and two heads.
Mm. And why would you do that?
To share information,
mm-hmm.
and to create a very strong vibration of love.
Mm-hmm. Is it like what we do on Earth, like sexual intercourse?
Yes, but on energetic level.
Mm. Do you make kids on this planet? How does this work?
You mean in general?
Mm.
We produce them in fabrics.
Mm.
We have a code.
Like laboratories.
Laboratories. Mm. We have a special DNA code that we copied and created.
Mm.
And there's a huge... Not really a computer, more like a crystal computer, very far advanced, I don't understand. And we put the code into the crystal, and then it generates the babies.
Mm.
And we can choose the features of the baby, so it's not...
Fixed.
Not fixed, and it's not coming out of the body of the beings. It's generated in huge laboratories.
Are you playing around with the DNA also, or you have a fixed code where you... You create?
No, I can change the DNA. Actually, there are big stores on the planet where you can buy different patterns of DNA. So if you're able to plant them into your body, so you can change you can morph your shape.
Your own DNA?
Yes.
Mm.
I can download information with it. Like, I don't read books. I plant the information into my DNA, so I have it in my mind automatically.
And where do they find this DNA? And in what form does it come? How do you physically, what is it made of? Like, practically, how does this work?
Mm-hmm.
Is it like a liquid that you drink, or something you touch?
No,
something?
It's stored in a shape of an egg, and it looks like a red, shiny helix, like the human DNA. It's a spiral shape.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And what do you do with it when you get it? How do you use it? Technically, I mean.
Yes, I use it to learn and to expand and to fulfill my wishes. It's also connected to fantasy, like whenever I want to create something, mm-hmm. because we are creative beings, mm-hmm. we plant the DNA in our bodies, so mm-hmm. we can instantly manifest those wishes. For example, if I wish to have another garden, I get the information in the DNA planted into my body, and then I can manifest it with my thoughts. But I first need to connect to the information.
And how do you plant the information of the DNA into your body? With intention, or you physically insert it in your body somehow? When you get it mm-hmm. from the store, I mean.
There's also DNA containers that are empty. I can charge them with my thoughts and intentions. And I rip off my skin and put them into my arm. Mm-hmm. But there's also like pre-stored DNA with fixed information. It's both as possible.
How do you spend your time? What is it that you do in this life?
I have a strong connection to black cats. Actually, it looks like the Black Panther on Earth, but with rainbow eyes. And I created it in a laboratory with the DNA of the Black Panther on Earth. Mm-hmm. I experimented with it, but not with bad intentions. I just wanted to create a new species that is more powerful. Mm-hmm. And I create the cats, and then I sell them to other people, to other beings on my planet.
You sell them?
Yes.
So you have like a currency or something when you exchange goods?
Yes, it's energy. People charge me with energy.
Awesome. So that's it. What you do with the majority of your time?
Yes, I create those cats, and I also collect material from fields and bring it to the sun. These are my two jobs. Yes.
Mm-mm-mm. Okay. So let's leave that scene now and let's move forward to an important day. What do you see?
I see myself in a big ranch in Africa with white animals around. I apparently have a rich family. I'm very wealthy. And I just stood up. I'm going in front of the house. The sun is shining. It's a beautiful day. And I'm going to a safari with my father.
Mm-hmm. And what happens there?
We go. In the beginning, everything is beautiful, but then I feel accident, trouble coming. Oh, people, soldiers coming mm-hmm. on horses, riding towards us, and they're shooting. Mm-hmm. They're shooting on us. They hit me with a bullet in my stomach, and I'm crying, I'm screaming, and I'm bleeding. And apparently I'm dying in the arms of my father.
You are a young girl.
I'm maybe 22, 23. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. And why did they do that? Who are these people?
They persecuted me because I was actually not allowed to be in this country. But my father gave it to me as a birthday present because he knew that it was always my deepest wish to go there. So we found this house, but actually it was a protected land. I don't know, it was not our land. So we somehow secretly went there with the help of a family member. I think it was a dangerous travel, but my father loved me so much that he tried to find a way to get me there, to show me the country, because I was always in love with Africa and the wild animals.
But why you were not allowed to be in this country?
Because I'm from a different tribe, a different race, that was actually confronting, or there was a war between two races, between black and white.
So you are white?
Mm-hmm.
And your family was?
No, my father's black.
Mm-hmm. And how come you're white?
Because my father's actually not my real father.
Mm-hmm.
He adopted me.
Mm-hmm.
He found me somewhere. He found me on a river. And then he took me with him. But actually this was not allowed back then. It was it was just not allowed that a black family or a black guy had a white daughter.
Mm. He found you when you were very young?
A baby.
Mm. So they threw you there? The real parents?
My real parents, yes.
Mm. So he found you and he wanted to take care of you?
Mm-hmm.
And what happened? Tell me. So they found you and they shot you?
They shot me, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Without even stopping me, they seemed to be very angry,
mm-hmm.
full of rage, and there was no way of preventing or running or stopping. They just directly shoot me into the stomach.
Mm-hmm. And what happens then?
My father tries to save me. He's complete in despair, doesn't know what to do. He sees there's a lot of blood coming out of my stomach. He has some white tissues and tries to wrap those tissues around the wound.
Mm-hmm.
And his hands are full of blood. Then lions come, because I could talk to them. They come and try to save me. They jump on the car. But they cannot do anything about it.
Mm.
And within 5 minutes, I'm dead.
Mm-hmm. So you died.
Mm-hmm.
And now you are out of the body. What did they do to your body?
Who?
What did your father do to it with your body?
He burned it.
Mm-hmm.
And took the ashes. And he put it in a container and left it near where lions are, because I was always very connected to them.
Mm-hmm. Why you were connected with the lions?
Because I was a lion in my past life, and I still had the connection, mm-hmm. or the ability to talk to them.
Mm-hmm.
So I, as a human incarnation, I could talk to them.
Mm-hmm. So now whatever happened has already happened, and you are on the other side of it. From that position, you can look back at this life and see it from a different perspective. Every life has a lesson and a purpose. As you look at this lifetime, what did you learn from it?
You mean in this African...
Yeah.
I learned the first thing is unconditional love to my father, although he is not physically my real father. Unconditional love, no matter, or not being distracted by outer appearance. And the other thing is to find a close connection to nature, being able to talk to animals and take this knowledge to my next life.
Mm. Mm-hmm. So that was the main purpose of the lifetime.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Were there any people in that lifetime that you know in this lifetime now?
No.
Mm-hmm. Now let's drift away from that life. We are drifting and floating away from that life. Do I have permission to ask questions?
Yes.
I know that the subconscious could have brought forth many different lifetimes for Katarina to see today. You chose to bring her first the lifetime as an ET. Why did you pick that lifetime? What were you trying to tell her?
Because the things that I saw there are related to this incarnation. There's some information that is useful for my mission here.
What is this information that will be useful for her?
Creating patterns that contain and store energy, and to give it to people to charge them with love or whatever good intention I may have.
Creating patterns?
Yes, creating patterns, energetical patterns, with my voice.
And how can Katharina do that?
In a state of trance, closing her eyes and imagining she's sitting in a big pyramid,
mm-hmm,
with a lot of windows or holes in it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm connecting the holes in the pyramid and form shapes.
And this will help people?
Yes, it's generating a frequency,
mm-hmm,
where I can put information in. Like the frequency is like a container that stores my intention.
Mm-hmm.
And with this intention, I can heal people energetically.
Mm-hmm.
I can dissolve pain and raise the frequency of people that ask me for help.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Has she ever done this before in this lifetime?
Yes, on Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Was she aware of it?
Yes, but she was aware that she was doing it,
mm-hmm,
but she was not aware that she should improve or go on working on those skills,
mm-hmm,
and also use this not to create only a song, but to heal, to give it to people.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay. Would you like to give her some more advice on how to do that, or you think she knows?
It's connected to the trees. The trees will give her more insights, mm-hmm, and information during the plant diet in Cuba. Will give her songs and frequencies that she can use, record and remember, so she can work with those frequencies. Yes, it's connected with the trees.
When you say record, you mean in her brain or in a...
No, in reality, so she doesn't forget the songs, because it's important to always remember the frequency, so she can remember it and work with it.
And how can she record these frequencies?
With a telephone, for example.
Oh, with a recorder?
Simple way, yes.
Mm-hmm. You also saw her a lifetime where she was a girl that she got shot in Africa. Why did you show her that lifetime?
Because it's related to a very strong connection to wild cats. And yes, she died, but it had a higher purpose, because her soul stored the connection to the wild cats. And this information is being transmitted to me.
So what does this have to do with her life now?
She has to go to the jungle,
mm-hmm,
and she will meet a real wild cat, real panther there.
Mm-hmm. And if you have any advice for her, what can she do there when she's connected with them?
You mean with the cat?
Mm-hmm.
By being physically near to them,
mm-hmm,
she can receive information and the energy of the cat that will be stored in her body. So she has the energetic signature of the cat inside of her that will give her a lot of power and also eternal connection to the cat.
Mm-hmm. So she has been incarnated as a wild cat before?
Yes, many times.
On Earth?
Yes.
What kind of cats?
Black panthers, lions, jaguar.
Mm-hmm. Why did she choose wild cats? Why is she choosing these felines, this race?
Because she has a lot of wild, savage power that wants to be expressed, and also those beings are not just cats, they are related, they have access to other dimensions. So actually they keep it in secret. They don't, I mean, they are not able to talk to people, but they have access to other dimensions. But sometimes when they meet the right people, they will give this ancient or secret knowledge to chosen people.
That's why they were using them in Egypt for healing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So Katarina is able to connect with them.
Yes.
If she chooses to.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So she has a list of questions today. I would like to start from the first question that has to do with her, with the pain. She still feels pain, guilt and disappointment in her heart, which is related to the abandonment, I'm sorry, of her father. She wants to know how she can heal it.
She can heal it by focusing on her mission on Earth, because her mission is so powerful and so full of love and light that everything that was in the past will be healed. She has to get rid of her self-doubts, because the self-doubts feed the pain, constantly feed the pain.
She has self-doubts?
Yes.
Why?
About her mission, because it's so big and so powerful and so full of mystery and magic that sometimes she thinks that she's living in a dream, or it's too abstract or stupid, and she's not able to realize it.
But why did she choose this experience in her childhood, to be abandoned by her father and to be mistreated by her stepmother?
To find herself again, because this pain is actually creating a balance, because she was born with extraordinary powers, and as we are here incarnated in a world of duality, there always have to be a balance. And I know it's a kind of extreme balance, but those dark patterns also serve as very powerful lessons, and she's on a good way. And by this, these lessons, she will find access to her own heart, otherwise it won't be possible. It's actually the access to her own heart. She should not forget it.
Through the pain?
Yes.
The emotional pain?
Yes.
How does this work? Because at the moment she feels the opposite. She feels that she cannot connect with her heart anymore. She finds it difficult.
Actually, she can do it, because there's always access to her heart that is not under the influence of the dark patterns. But the problem is that she's afraid to really fully feel the pain, because from a certain point, when it gets too profound or too deep, she stops the process or starts to hide or run away. But as soon as she will be able to fully accept and feel the pain...
How can she do that? To feel the pain and accept it? What method would you suggest or advise?
Being alone in a sacred meditative state, taking time for herself, and also visualizing the situations where she felt the pain, and then fully accepting it. And it's also a great lesson in not judging, because she chose it so she can grow.
So bring back the memories, relive it, try not to judge it, that moment, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then?
Also breathing, where she feels the pain, she should do longer breathing exercises and also singing.
Mm-hmm.
Singing is very important to release the pain.
Mm-hmm. Crying also?
Yes, every expression of emotion.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And step by step, it will get better.
Mm-hmm. Why did she choose this experience? You said something earlier, but I would like to ask again if what she wanted to learn from this. What was the lesson to be learned?
The lesson to be learned is to accept other people, not to judge them, and to love them unconditionally. Because as she feels the pain, humans automatically start to judge other people.
Yeah.
But if she really wants to grow spiritually, she has to learn firstly not to judge other people, not to judge herself, and secondly to love other people even if they hurt her unconditionally. And by being able to love her parents unconditionally, although there's so much pain, she will be able to love all the people, every person she meets on her life journey, unconditionally, and give them a lot of power.
So that's something that she should do fully, to forgive them fully.
Yes.
Because she hasn't done this yet, I guess, it's holding back.
This is the point, yes. She hasn't forgive them so far.
Mm-mm. Does she have, by chance, any karmic relationships to any of them?
Yes, she was a princess in one of her past lives, and she was learning a lot from her father, but yes, she was also related to the ex-wife of her father. I totally see the relation to past lives. It was a very powerful family, but with a lot of trouble, and somehow there's a family pattern that is being incarnated all over again until it's resolved.
So it's a part karmic situation.
Yes, it's a pattern that hasn't been resolved.
Okay, is it resolved now through this experience?
It can be, but it's not yet resolved.
Is there something that Katarina can do in this lifetime that she could resolve it and release?
Yes, the key is to forgive, and forgiveness is not something, not a process in the mind, but she has to feel it in her heart.
How will she know that she has done it?
By feeling eternal peace,
mm-hmm.
or more stable inside.
Mm-hmm.
And also being able to tell her parents that she truly loves them without being feeling shame.
Her stepmother as well, I guess.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She hasn't done that.
No.
Mm. You said something earlier that we orchestrate this kind of opposite experiences, like she came in with extraordinary abilities and then she chose to have this very challenging childhood.
Mm-hmm.
And if we can focus on that a little bit more, because I would like to understand how that works. Because it looks like she gets, like, from my perspective, she came in with very, very, how you said, like, extraordinary abilities, and looks like she kind of lost them, let's say, during this challenging childhood. Why would that happen?
Because the powers are not just there. It's not a linear process, but in every incarnation, they have to be discovered. And if they would just be there, there would be no learning process. So
to win them.
Yes.
To activate them, let's say.
Exactly, yes. And also to evolve them, because as soon as she's looking inside of herself and looking within, she will discover them.
Is there something we can do now to help her release some of the pain that she's holding from her childhood?
She should try to connect to the trees. They will help her a lot.
Can you help her now? Assist her in any way you think it's appropriate now that she's connected to you to activate this process for her to heal?
Yes, I can show her how it feels to be connected with the heart so she can remember it.
Mm-hmm. You mean you can do this now?
Mm-hmm.
And she will be able to recognize it?
Yes.
And express it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is it like opening the heart?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I feel a glowing energy in my chest.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's opening.
Mm-hmm. And how can she do that more often? How can she connect more with her heart? I guess the first step would be to initiate this forgiveness,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And from there on, she will be able to connect with her heart more often, more easy?
Yes, there's also other things that I would recommend her.
Mm-hmm.
One thing is try to meditate every day, be in complete silence to find her center.
Mm-hmm.
And then she also should try to express herself with her heart, like some creative activity, for example, dancing or singing.
Mm-hmm.
So she can transmute the creative energy through her heart, or she can transmute the pain with that creative energy through her heart. And she should do this regularly.
Mm-hmm. She says that her inner child keeps disconnecting her from herself in the external world.
Mm-hmm.
How can she heal this pattern?
She has to give the child attention, because the inner child is seeking for attention, and by causing pain, it's just a way of communicating with her.
Mm-hmm.
So the inner child, it's a sign that the inner child wants to be seen,
yeah.
and wants to, yes, she should take care of it and try to connect, communicate and find a relationship and not judge herself for the pain, but just unconditionally love the inner child and approach it like a mother.
How can she find the inner child? How can she recognize it and connect with it?
By meditating and visualizing it, it will come to her easily.
Is there something that she could imagine visually that can help this process, like her in the in her childhood or something, or not necessarily?
Yes, she can imagine to sit in front of the inner child, like she as a person, and then the inner child is sitting next to her,
mm-hmm.
and then the child will start to talk to her
mm.
and give her information or whatever.
Mm, to have an internal discussion then.
Yes.
With it.
Mm-hmm.
So the goal will be to connect with it and to pamper it.
Yes. To listen, to take care of it, to give it loving energy and not to judge it. She is too harsh to herself sometimes.
Yeah, and she's missing that because as a child she didn't get enough attention, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now that she's older, she can heal her past, right, in a way.
Mm-hmm.
She's asking if she should go to Cuba in February or March.
As soon as possible.
Why?
Because she's in a strong process. And here in Berlin, she's distracted over and over again. So she stumbles and she's unstable, and she needs to have a safe place where she can retreat and focus on her process. And also being in nature is very important.
Mm-hmm.
So she should go as soon as possible.
I guess connection is what is her mission in this lifetime?
Her mission is to connect spiritually to the power of the trees, which is also connected to the power of the panther because they climb the trees. She will receive energetic patterns that will be stored in her body, and by singing she can create vibrations and give it to other people. So she can give this energy to other people so people can heal themselves.
Mm-hmm.
It's like an energetic healing.
So in Cuba she will have the chance to connect with it, with nature, and work with this. She's asking why she cannot, why she's scared to show her emotions.
Because she was being judged in her childhood all the time. And now she's scared that someone could judge her emotions. Like this is triggering the inner child again.
Yeah,
because the inner child sees the judgment as a threat of the external world. And this fear, it's actually a fear of being judged, or fear of being not good enough and then being judged because of this.
And what can she do about that? How can she heal this?
She should sit in front of a mirror every day for 10 or 15 minutes and look into her eyes without being distracted, sending herself loving energy and telling herself that she's good enough and beautiful. And she should do this for at least 1 month.
Another question is how she can connect with the power of the Black Panther?
There's already a plan. She will spiritually connect during the plant diet in Cuba, but she will also go to the jungle in Peru or Latin America in general, and she will meet a real Black Panther there.
So animal form.
Yes, as a real animal.
Until
then she can call the Black Panther spirit whenever she wants to, and she should do it in her ceremony room. In front of the altar, maybe putting a picture of the Black Panther in front of her, and just in a very like in a matter of devotion, asking for help.
Yeah, as a prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And then the spirit will of the animal will connect with her.
Yes.
And why is she connected with the, she feels this attraction and this connection with the Black Panther? What's the reason of this connection?
Because she was one in her previous lives.
Did she have many previous lives on Earth?
Yes, mostly as wild cats.
Human?
No.
Not many?
No. Ah, you mean human incarnations?
Yes. Human incarnation.
Yes, there are some of them.
Sorry, going back to the Black Panther, I would like to ask you also how can she use this the teachings from the Black Panther?
Write it down, because if she asks for help, the Black Panther also will give her practical advice, like little teachings, what she can practice in her everyday life. She should write down her process each evening before going to bed, so she can go deeper into it, and write down the process so she can see how she's improving or developing. But by connecting and asking, she will be given teachings and also tasks from the spirit.
And with the trees, how can she connect more with the trees?
She's already very strongly connected, and she should forget about putting herself under pressure because sometimes she thinks that she lost the connection or she has to do something.
Mm.
That's not the case. The trees always are with her and are always connected to her.
Mm.
And the two most, the two easiest methods are either meditating, it's actually the same as with the panther, or by singing and using a rattle or drumming. And just singing spontaneously, freely, information. Yes.
Will flow?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. How, why? How does this work?
Because the sound creates a vibration that's information, or like she's a bridge between the 3D world and the spiritual world.
Mm-hmm.
And the tree spirits, they work with energetic vibrations that will go into her body, so she kind of translates it to words.
Mm. Another question she has is if she should connect more to her ancestors, because she feels that they want to tell her something.
Yes, the ancestors already approached her. She doesn't have to do something actively, but just being aware of little signs that she will be given, and she also, she's able to feel their presence.
Why they are here? Are they here visiting her?
They want to support her,
because
they see she's trapped in some patterns, and they want to help her to release those patterns. Yes, they want to help her.
And with what way do they help her?
Yeah, the teachings can be very tough because they enhance the pain she feels.
Mm-hmm.
That's a way of telling or making her feel that they are present and there.
That's why she feels dense when in their presence.
Yes.
She said, yeah.
Yes.
Mm.
It's like an encrypted message or lesson, and also patterns that need to be resolved.
Wow.
Because her ancestors had the same painful patterns, but she can release it.
Mm. Because she says that she was thinking that how to resolve the pattern of an unfulfilled wish that was given from mother to son to daughter and so on.
It had to do with expectations of a very deep longing for something.
It's from her?
Okay. No, from the ancestors.
Uh-huh.
It's a longing for a love or a promise that was made in a relationship. It was not fulfilled because there were expectations.
A relationship that she was involved?
You mean Katharina?
Mm.
No, it was like between man and woman.
Mm. And what does Katharina have to do? Has to do with it?
She has to take care of her relationship.
Her current relationship,
yes, because it's very, the love is very powerful and strong and beautiful. And she has to be careful not to have too high expectations.
From what?
In expecting or making herself dependent of the love. She should try to be free and to love unconditionally without having expectations or without wanting something.
Mm-mm.
Or without thinking, I need this love to be fulfilled, because this is actually not true.
Mm.
Because this pattern was unfulfilled, very strong expectations in a love relationship that is passed to the next generations.
Mm-hmm. She recently felt the presence of the mother of her father.
She needs help.
Mm-hmm. What kind of help does she need?
She's not free and she wants to be free. mm-hmm. and she's asking for help.
Mm-hmm. Can we connect with her now?
Mm-hmm.
Can we call her in? Okay, so we are calling now the subconscious of Gertrude to come in and connect with us. Is she here?
Mm-hmm.
Hello. Thank you for connecting with us. we would like to help you, and we would like to know what can we do about you. You recently visited Katarina.
Mm-hmm. I have kind of a secret in my life that I haven't told anyone, and this is why it's still stuck in my body.
Mm-hmm.
It has to do with a love relationship which was very strong but also painful and unfulfilled.
Mm-hmm.
And because I never had the ability to speak with anyone about it, I'm still stuck in the story, and
mm-hmm.
I want to be free.
So we would like to give you the opportunity to help you here today. Katarina would really love to help you. And so I would like to ask you if it would be helpful for you to share your secret.
Yes, when I was married, I had a relationship with a younger man that I fell in love with. I actually wanted to be with him, but back then I was not able to talk about it, so I kept it in secret.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, basically I was lying to my man the whole life until he died. So I also kept this secret until I died.
Yeah, but I guess you did it because you wanted to protect him, right? You didn't want to hurt him.
Yes.
So I think I completely understand why you did it, and you had a very good motive behind. I think you should forgive yourself for that. And I'm sure, I guess he has forgiven you as well, right?
Yes.
So now that you have shared your secret with us, and we really, really appreciate that you have done, would you like to go back to the light? Go back to the spirit side?
Yes, please.
Okay. So you're free now.
Thank you.
Go.
Thank you.
And have a wonderful journey. And you are loved and you are forgiven.
Thank you.
Thank you for being with us. Can we return to the connection with the subconscious with Katarina?
Mm-hmm.
I had a session with her partner a few weeks ago, and his subconscious mentioned a mission that they both have in Berlin.
Mm-hmm.
Would you like to give her more information about that?
Yes, they have to build an energy pyramid in specific locations in Berlin.
Mm-hmm.
They will find it out by themselves. I don't want to say everything, but they actually know what to do.
Okay.
They just have to be aware. They will be given the right information in the right time. And yes, they actually have the right crystals to work with. They need to be clear and clean, and they have to make sure to put good intentions into them. But it's actually an energetic grid that the earth needs, also with other energetic portals or grids that are being built all over the world that will stabilize especially the area around Berlin, so it helps people to ascend.
Mm. And is this mission involving the two of them, Andres and Katarina? Only the two of them?
No, 6 or 7 people.
Okay. And how will they be able to find out who they are?
They will feel it.
They will feel it, okay. And is there a time frame for this mission? When it should be accomplished?
Until late summer next year.
Okay. And do they know which locations, the spots where they have to do this?
Yes. It's connected to the shape and symbols that they were given.
Okay. So is there anything you would like to add on this? Any information you would like to give her now?
Colors are related. Colors of the rainbow. Mm. This is important to know.
Mm-hmm.
They need to be combined.
Mm. That's something that we talked about last time we met.
Mm-hmm.
So is there anything else that you would like, that you would wish that she would have asked today?
I would like to let her know that she's also very much connected to angels and she's being protected by angels. Also the numbers that she receives come from angels and she has a very strong connection and there's nothing to be scared of and nothing to be worried because the angels protect her.
So she constantly have some guardian angels around her?
Yes.
How many?
3, mm-hmm. 4.
4, yeah. I think most of us humans, we have 4 guardians, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is she aware of that?
Actually, yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So this could be also a connection with her, for her, if she would like to get some guidance.
Yes.
And it's a very beautiful one.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any message for me?
Share your knowledge about crystals and stones and work with them to open the portal. You know what you have to know to complete the mission. There's nothing that needs to be learned or nothing that needs to be actively seeking. Everything that needs to be known is inside of you and you will know it intuitively at the right time. Yes, you have a lot of supportive light beings that also connect to Katarina and Andres when they are here. And your energy gives the right information to them, like it's kind of uplifting them and connecting to their souls and remembering their own souls about their mission. So it's very important.
Mm-hmm. What could we do together? Is there something you would like to share? Or it's something that will come in the future?
Make music, meditate together.
Mm-hmm.
Sending good intentions to the universe.
So we are about to go. I would like to ask if there is a message that you want her. Is there anything else you would like to tell her before we close?
Yeah, she's always connected to the divine love. And even if she feels pain or she's in a dark sorrow, her core is indestructible and always connected to the light. And there's always a little door inside of herself that she can enter and connect to the divine source. And she should trust her process. She's on the right way.